Namaste Gurukulians, I hope you all are fine and safe at your houses, and today we are going to start with the second chapter of EBS, that is bones and muscles. Have you ever wondered what gives shape to your body? I just want you to do a thing. You just see at your arm and you just try to press it. If you try to press your arm, you will feel that over the body, complete body, you can see it is covered with skin, and under the skin there's a soft thing inside. Okay, so all together what we are made up of, that we are going to study today in this chapter, that is called as bones and muscles, the second chapter of EBS of your class. And in this chapter all together we are going to study, I told you, as about bones and muscles. So in this chapter the very first and the main concern is about bones. But before proceeding further, as I was telling you, you just try to do one thing. As you press your skin like this, you will feel there is a soft muscular thing beneath the skin, that is known as muscles. So if you overlook it, just try to take a look. Skin, muscles, and then bones. In the body, you are able to see or feel three things. Completely, body is covered with skin. Thereafter, under the skin, we have muscles. And beneath the muscles, you can feel the hard part inside. This is known as bone. Or our body is made up of muscle and bones. So, two main things. Muscles and bones. So in this chapter we are going to study about this. So body, what you call a body? You know, we know about, we have earlier studied about living and non-living things. We know that what are living things, we know what are non-living things. So as you classify living things further, there are certain things which help living being to be a living being. So muscles and bones are also included in that part. You can see that this table, chair, these don't have any muscles or bone inside them. So every particular thing is made up of smaller components. So our body is made up of muscles and bones. And these muscles and bones, these are interconnected together. And these give a framework to the body. Means with the help of bones and muscles, our body, I am able to stand up, I am able to move my body, my limbs, and I am able to speak. So these are helpful in the support, protection and movement of the body. So now further, if you move, you can say that these bones and muscles, but what these are helping, these are giving support, shape, and these are also helpful in movement. So as I am saying that it gives support, support means it is giving support to the body, complete body, as well as it is protecting the organs inside the body. You know that inside your body there are soft and vital organs. There are many important organs in the body which are very crucial for the life, which are like brain, heart, lungs, stomach and all. So these all are protected by the bones. So these bones, these not only support, these give shape also. Shape means I am standing. So you can, draw a drawing. Like suppose you need to draw a picture of a person. So there will be a proper shape of the body. So this shape, this structure is provided by this framework of bones. Okay. Thirdly, movement. So this skeleton, these muscles, these are also helping us to move from one place to other. If suppose the feet bone or the leg bone is fractured, thereafter what will happen? We will not be able to move properly. That is why we are saying that these bones and muscles, these are helpful in the movement also. Okay. Now muscles. These muscles are attached with the bones. These muscles are attached with the bones. Suppose this bone is to be moved. So the muscles here, these are attached with the bones, and these thereby are helping these bones to move. Okay. So finally, I have told you three things, that this gives us support, shape and help in the movement of the body. One more thing, if there will be no bones in the body, then what will happen? Our body is just like a, suppose I'm giving example of a tent. You have seen a tent. Inside the tent, there are pillars provided which give the shape to the tent. So if you remove the bones from the body, so it will be none or less, it will be a heap of muscle or skin. Okay, so bones are helping to give it a structure, a shape, a rigid body which is able to move itself with the action or with the reflex action of brain. Brain is giving command to the body to move, to work. Okay, and bones and muscles, these are helping in implementation of this command. So now, as one more thing, if you just give a name to all this framework of this of the bone, all these framework of bone, these are collectively given a single name which is known as skeleton. It might be a very familiar word to you. Skeleton means, which is, skeleton is a framework of bone. Okay, so all these bones are collectively, these make a structure which is known as skeleton. So skeleton is made up of bones. How many bones we have in the body? We have 206 bones in the body. We have 206 bones in the body. If you talk about a newborn baby, a newborn child, it has 300, more than 300 bones. It has more than 300 bones in the body. But later on, as the body grows, you know, as if you are small heighted child, as you will grow up, you are now you are in 5th class, thereafter you will go in 6th class, then 10th class, then you will grow up older. So your height will also increase, and thereby with the increment of your height, your bone height will also be increased. So bones are also getting increase in the height. So these 300 bones, earlier they are 300 in newborn baby child. So thereafter they fuse together. They fuse together in newborn baby child. There are 300 bones which thereafter fuse together to finally make how many bones? 206 bones in the body. Okay. So now this was about how many bones we have. Now we will discuss in detail about the skeleton. Okay. How many bones are there? What are their functions? So first of all, we need to know that what is a bone. A bone is a hard structure of the body, and a bone comprises of different parts. Now I will show you. If I try to draw a bone, so outer side of the bone, it is known as the hard part, hard or compact bone. So the outer part is known as hard or compact bone, and inside there is a soft and spongy bone. Spongy or soft. Okay. So this inside part, which is known as spongy bone, it is also known as bone marrow. Inside there is a fluid which is known as bone marrow. And inside this bone marrow, so I'm telling three things you need to remember. The outer covering, the hard outer covering, is known as hard or compact bone. The inner bone is known as soft or spongy bone, and this is filled with bone marrow. Okay, this is filled with bone marrow, and in this bone marrow there is a production of RBC, and it is also held in the storage of fat. We have already read about fat. What is fat? So RBC, you need to know about RBC, that you know that our blood is of red color. So this red color is provided by the red blood cells in the blood. Okay, so these red blood cells these are produced here in the bone marrow. So this was about the structure of the bone. We know that our complete body is made up of bones. So all these bones are same in the size? No. Every organ has a different aspect. So if you talk about a skeleton, skeleton is made up of skull. This upper portion is known as skull, ribs, which are protecting the lungs inside, and spinal cord or the backbone, vertebral column. Thereafter, you have limbs. Okay, so limbs means hands and legs. So these all comprises and these make a complete skeleton, which gives the shape, structure, and protection to the body. So skeleton system, what you will call a skeleton system as? Skeleton system, it is the framework of bone which provide protection, gives shape and help in the movement of the body. Okay. So thereafter, one more thing, that what a bone is made up of. A bone is made up of calcium and phosphorus. Earlier in the chapter eating habit, eating right, I have discussed this thing, that there are certain minerals in the body which are very crucial, very important for the body. These are like calcium, phosphorus, magnesium. So these are one of them, calcium and phosphorus. These are minerals, and bone is made up of calcium and phosphorus. Okay. Apart from this, a bone is also supplied with blood vessels and nerves. Okay. Bone is also supplied with blood vessels and nerves. Okay. So this was about bone. Okay. 2, 3, 4 things I have told you. These are very brief points. Very important points you must know about the bone. So I told you that the bone, it is made up of calcium and phosphorus. It is helping in the movement, and outer part is hard, compact bone. Inner part is spongy, soft part. It is filled with bone marrow, and this bone marrow helps in the production of RBC, and it also helps in the storage of fat. So now one more part we will discuss today, that is about the skull. Skull is the most hard part. It is the hardest part of the skeleton, and it is made up of 22 bones. So I am writing it here. Skull, it is made up of 22 bones. It is made up of 22 bones. If you try to touch your skull, you will feel that this is the hard part, and it is made up of 22 bones. And these 22 bones, some more things are there. You must know that 8 bones, among these 22 bones, 8 bones are flat, which like this upper portion. This upper portion, this is made up of 8 flat bones, which is protecting inside. What is there inside this cover box? There is brain. So these flat bones, these are covering the vital organ, which is brain. Apart from these 8 bones, it is covering the brain. And rest, how many bones are left now? 14 bones. So these 14 bones, these cover the face. These form frame for the face. So if you have ever seen a skeleton in the TV also, or in the books also, if you have, you will be able to see that over this area, over the skull area, there will be a hard part, complete hard part, which is made up of 8 flat bones. There are 14 bones which are fused together to give a framework to the face. Now you are able to see that as I am speaking. So my lower jaw is moving, upper jaw and the lower jaw. So these upper and lower jaw, these are movable. Not upper and lower jaw, only lower jaw is movable. Okay, upper is not movable, only lower jaw is movable. Okay, so this lower jaw is movable, and because of this, we are able to speak. and we are able to produce. We are able to produce sound because of vocal cords, and because of this movable jaw, we are able to move our mouth. Okay. So this I was telling you about skull. Okay. In the skull, what are different things apart from these bones? You have eyes and these sockets, and apart from that, you have this area which is known as nose. So if you try to press the nose, you will feel that it is hard, but not that much hard as a bone is. And similarly, if you try to touch your ear, it is also soft in nature. So these ear and nose, ear and nose, these are not made up of bones, rather these are made up of soft bone, which is known as cartilage. Okay, so ear and nose, these are not made up of bones. Like this is very hard, and if you try to move it, touch it, this is very soft bone, so this is known as cartilage. Okay, now one more thing, that between the skull and brain, I told you that the skull, it is protecting the brain inside it, and between the skull and the brain, there is a fluid filled inside. Okay, there is a fluid, liquid filled inside between the skull, between the skull and the brain portion. So this fluid, it is helping the brain to be protected from shocks and jerks. It is protecting the brain as you move. Okay, as you fall down, if some accident happens, so it will not affect our brain directly. The fluid filled inside, it will protect the brain. So this was all about for today's class, for today's video lecture, that is, we are studying the chapter bone and muscle. So we have discussed few points. I'm going to summarize a bit about them, that our body is made up of bones and muscles, and here we are discussing more about bones. So bones, it forms a framework that is known as skeleton, which provide shape, structure, and help in the movement of the body. Thereafter, I told you that this bone is made up of outer hard part and inner spongy and soft part, and thereafter it is filled with the bone marrow, which is helping in the production of RBC and also helping the storage of fat. Thereafter, I told you about the bone, it is made up of calcium and phosphorus, and it is supplied with the blood and nerves. And thereafter, I told you about the skull. Skull is made up of 22 bones, 8 are flat bones, and 14 are the bones which are making the frame for the face. Thereafter, we have upper jaw and lower jaw. Lower jaw is movable. And thereafter, the cartilage is part, ear and nose. So that was all for today. Rest of the chapter will be carried in the next video lecture. And for this time, you are going to read it thoroughly, because it might be a bit difficult or new to you. So you need to revise it again and again. Fine. The next portion will carry in the next video lecture. Okay. Namaste.